Hello friends, welcome back. In today's video I will show you how to make a piano in C# Windows Forms. So in the previous tutorial I showed you the UI part of our piano, and in this tutorial I'll show you the coding part. So let us start. So now here is our application that we designed in the previous video. So I'll select my form, and in its properties I'll change its creep preview to true. And now make sure you have downloaded the audio file for our notes from the link given in the description below, and you have to download in the debug folder of your application in the bin. So now I'll double click this button, and before that here I'll make a new method. I will name it as play, and in these parentheses I'll pass a string argument which will be string note path, in which we will specify the path of our note which we will be using. And now in here we'll type system.media.soundplayer. Give it a name as I am naming it as player, is equal to new system.media.soundplayer. In here in parentheses we'll just type the our string, that is notepad, and now close it off. Now after that we'll type player.play. So in here actually we created a sound player, and which will play the note path, the or path note that we downloaded, and then it will play. So, and now in our click we'll type play, and then I'll name it at notes audio. That is the folder in which I have downloaded all the notes. You can download it from the link in the description to my OneDrive. You will download that notes audio folder, and in here I'll type c1.wav and then close it off. Okay, so now we have to do this with all the keys, but before that I will just run my application and test that does it works or not. So here it is building. Here's my, this is the form, and it can play the C note because I have done the code for this button only, and if I click on any other button it won't play. And now we have to do the same with all the button here. Like this was C1, so D1, E1, F1, G1, A1 and B1, and this will be C#1, D#1, F#1, G#1 and A#1. So I'll double click this C#, and in here I'll just first of all copy this and paste it here, and I will make this C#1. So now if you have downloaded these notes with some another name, then you have to use those name, and in make sure that those notes are in the debug folder of your application. To find your debug application, just click on the right click your solution and then click on open folder in file explorer, and then this file explorer will open, and then bin debug, and here is my the folder notes audio, where I have all my audio file, and you have to do the same. Okay, and now
and repeat the process. Now finally our application is complete and I am running this. So here's my form. I can play all the notes with my mouse click. So but I have not added that I have to play with my keys. So I am going to add that now. So for that, just select your form and in its properties and in your actions, I will just go to key, and in here in the key press, I will type if e dot key char is equal to, and then in single quotes, C, then make sure that no, then just copy it from here. And paste it here. So now it will play with the keys, and I have to do this for all my notes. So I'm going to copy this and now paste it. So actually this will be A, this will be S, this will be D, this will be F, G, H, and now I will make this D1, E1, F1, G1, and then A1. One more time I'm going to paste, and if it would be J, then it will be one. Okay, and for these black keys it will be with W. So if key card is equal to W, then it will play C sharp 1. I'm going to pop. And if it is E, then D sharp. And then if T, then F sharp. Here G sharp and for U it will be A sharp. So we have done it for all the notes. Let me see, and now I am running this application again. So here is my form. I am trying to play with my keys. So as you can see, it is playing with my keys also, and it is fine. So if you want to add more octaves here, then you can just copy this. Let me show you. and paste your buttons here. I will change its name to C2 and I'll double click, and in here I will just make it C2. And now so if I click this now, it will play like this. So you can add more octaves here like this, and that's it. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel and leave a like and comment on this video. Or if you're stuck anywhere or you have some error in this application, you can ask me in the comments below and I will surely try to solve your problem. Thanks for watching.